Welcome to Vice City Academy, a video series designed to provide players of Vice City Multiplayer with the necessary information to improve when it comes to game mechanics and strategy. Since this is the first episode, today's episode will be mostly aimed at beginners. I'm going to assume that you've been playing Vice City Multiplayer for about 1 or 2 days and have a basic understanding of how it is. You may often notice that when playing Vice City Multiplayer, problems crop up. Problems with sometimes you shoot a player, you see blood come out of the player you shot, but they won't lose health. Other times you'll be chasing a player in the car. You'll crash into the side of the player's car, trying to spin them out, but nothing happens. Let's take a closer look at some clips where this kind of stuff happens. Notice that in a second I'll hit the other player with a shotgun. Blood will come out of his character, but his health won't drop. Here is the same clip again, but in slow motion this time. Keep an eye on the character's health bar as the shot hits him and the blood comes out. Notice how it didn't drop? Here's another example. Again, same as before, notice that it hit the other player, but their health doesn't drop. So, why does this happen? The first thing to realise about Vice City Multiplayer is that everything doesn't happen in real time, and that there's a sort of delay. Actions from your player, and every other player, are delayed. This includes running, shooting, jumping, and driving. There's a number of factors which can add to this problem. However, one of the main ones, and the major ones, is latency, also known as delay. Latency can be measured by the player's ping. This is the amount of time it takes for data to send from your PC across the internet to the server and back. Ping is measured in milliseconds. So for example, you can press F5 in-game to open the scoreboard, where it will show your ping. So if you had a ping of 250 milliseconds, this would equate to a quarter of a second. So your ping, the other player's ping, how well your game is running, and how well the other player's game is running, can all add together and have some kind of outcome on the delay. So if this is a problem, then how can we counter it? We can try to compensate for this by lead aiming. Lead aiming is when you try to fire at where your target will be, as opposed to where he currently is on the screen. Here's an example. In this clip we can see that the player is running to the right in a slight arc, but pretty straight. This makes it pretty easy to decide where he's going to be next. So I fire in front of him where he's running, and as you can see the shotgun hits him. There is no blood, but he loses health. Again, I quickly see that the player is running around me to my left, so I fire ahead of him where he currently is, in the direction that he's going, and hit him in the process. Here is one last combat example, this time with an assault rifle. Combat isn't the only thing affected by delay. As previously mentioned, vehicles are also affected by delay. In this clip I'm trying to chase a player in a vehicle. I try to get as close to him as I can so I can spin him out of control. But as you see, once I crash into the side of him at the back, he doesn't spin out of control. You can notice that there's tire marks left over from where he should have spun, and that my game kind of shows me that he's spun out of control, but this is quickly corrected when he is going in a straight line again. So essentially what is happening here is that the player is actually a little bit further than I do see in my screen, so that means when I clip the back end of his car, he's actually just a little bit too far out from my reach, and basically what happens then is that in my game it thinks that I've hit him, so that's why you see him spin out of control for like half a second. Then after it's quickly corrected as the server updates information and shows that he's still going straight. Knowing this, I try to move up even closer. So on my screen I'm up beside the side of his car, but on his screen he sees me right at the back of his car. So then I move in to the right. And as you see, he spins out of control. Going back to combat, in terms of how far you should lead aim ahead is determined by your ping versus your opponent's ping. There is no way to easily determine how far you should shoot ahead. It's something you just have to get a feel for by having experience. On top of that, you'll also most likely be facing players with a variety of pings. This means that sometimes you'll have to lead aim more and sometimes less. Sometimes it's almost near impossible to lead aim because the player's ping is either too high or they're moving too erratically, such as in circles. both of these can make it very difficult to target your opponent properly. This image gives a rough estimate of how far you should shoot ahead if your ping was an average of 50. Obviously, if the other player is running directly towards you, or directly away from you, or standing still, you don't need to lead aim. As a concept, lead aiming can be very confusing and not very intuitive at all. What you see on the screen isn't actually really what's there. If you're new to Vice City Multiplayer, lead aiming can be very difficult in general. Gameplay in Vice City Multiplayer can be very fast, making predictions even more difficult. However, with time and practice, the gameplay will begin to feel much slower and that you'll have more control over your reactions.